A cloud to ground lightning in the vicinity. This is the refinery right here. And as we zoom in, you can see this lightning strike at 4:50. Now, this is the actual area where the fire is occurring now, but there were a few lightning strikes in the area, and that was just feet away from this particular fire. So live Mega Doppler 3 picking up on the lightning strikes very close by. We do have more showers and storms that are moving through South Jersey. I'll be back with more on that coming up. Larry?
All right, thanks a lot, Kath. Well, as I've been saying, the smoke can be seen for miles from this fire. Bob Kelly is here to tell us about some of the road closures. Now, this is on 130 and 295, right, Bob? So those roads have to be affected.
Exactly. Route 130 southbound, right where it meets up with 295. Local closures, but let me give you an idea. This is our camera that's atop the Walt Whitman Bridge. You can see the smoke billowing into the air. There's gaper delays over all of the bridges, 295, 130, as well as even on I-95 on the Jersey side. Again, this is just south of the Walt Whitman Bridge. Let's go to the maps to give you an idea of the exact location. Again, it's on the Jersey side. Here's your Walt Whitman Bridge, just south, right here where 130 and 295 kind of meet, right there in West Deptford. So 130 is closed from the base of the Walt Whitman Bridge to south of that fire scene. Route 45 is closed as well. There are numerous fire companies, locals responding, as you heard the fellow on the phone. If they're needed, they'll be called in. Gaper delays on I-95. And even here on the Philadelphia side, I-95 is slow between Center City and the airport as folks just slow down to get a glimpse of the smoke on the opposite side of the river. Larry and Alicia, back over to you.
All right, thank you very much, Bob. Just to wrap up what we've been talking about, if we can take the picture one more time, just to show people again the story. This is the Sunoco refinery in West Deptford, New Jersey. It is right across from the Naval Yard. This started with a lightning strike that was witnessed just before 5 o'clock. The important news is right now, what is burning is not dangerous to nearby residents. It is under control, we are told, even though it may not look like that right now. They are going to let this tank burn out and just make sure it doesn't spread to any of the other tanks in the area. Right now, it is being handled by the Sunoco Fire Department. No other fire departments are being called in, and right now, there are not any injuries. That will bring you up to date for right now. We'll continue to follow this, and if there's an update, of course, we'll break in.
And still more breaking news. Within the past half hour, we received word from Texas that Lady Bird Johnson, widow of President Lyndon Johnson, has died. Her real name was Claudia Taylor Johnson, and she became known as a passionate conservationist during her years as First Lady. Her husband died in 1973. Lady Bird Johnson was 94 years old.